sins and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings flow, or as the curse is bound.
brothers and sisters, as we come in this time, just want to welcome you to this, our service, Grand Emmy Church. This is the second Sunday in December, however, it's the third Sunday of Advent. And indeed, we are grateful once again to be in the presence of the Lord. The psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And so indeed, we are glad to be in the presence of the Lord, to worship God, to give him praise and to give him glory. I invite you to join us in worship if you're listening, whether through Facebook or Zoom, whatever medium, open your hearts and receive what God has in store for us this morning. As we declare this morning that we are overcomers, as we receive the oil of joy, as God has intended for us to have joy in our lives this morning. Hallelujah. To God be all the glory, to God be all the praise, as we continue to worship God. At this time, we're going to have praise and worship by the praise team, and then we will have the reading of the Advent litany.
Wait upon the Lord, shall renew their strength. Oh, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Oh, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not was sick for so long, until his flesh fell from his bone. He had sores from the crown of his head. That's just what the Bible says. Wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Oh, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. Oh, they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. If you're sick and can't get well, and your doctor just cannot tell, turn it over to the Lord. He will heal you, I know he will. See, and no matter how upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Oh, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. Oh, they shall run and not be weary. Oh, they shall walk and not faint. So teach me, Lord. Teach me, Lord, how to wait. So teach me, Lord. So teach me, Lord.
Sister Berta Stephen and Sister Dolores Baldwin to read the Advent Litany and do the lighting.
When I look around, there are shadows of sadness, depression, families grieving, persons in homeless shelter, people in prison, people who have become invisible and forgotten, and celebrations overshadowed by a global pandemic.
In the face of grief, in the face of loss and sadness, we live in joyful anticipation of the coming of Jesus Christ, reminding that even now in God's presence, we have fullness of joy. We will live lives of joy, dancing and praising, laughing and singing, even as we await God's promised eternal joy.
We receive God's gift of joy as a reminder that beyond this temporary life of sorrow and testing, a time will come when there will be an abundance of flowers and singing and joy. The deserts will become as green as the mountains of Lebanon, as lovely as Mount Carmel or the plain of Sharon. There the Lord will display his glory, the splendor of our God.
Today we ask God to refill those places in our hearts where joy is fading or missing. In this Advent season, let joy fill our hearts.
No matter how far we feel from the spirit of the season, God promises to decorate us with love and with joy.
We light these candles as a sign of our hope and our peace in the beautiful things of this season. Not just the things that glitter and flash, but the deeper things, the beauty of the heart and the soul, the beauty of love shared in service and hospitality.
We light this candle of joy because company is coming. May the light of the candle say to all that God's joy is coming on earth as it already is in heaven. Brothers and sisters in Christ, be not afraid. God's joy is at hand.
Study to warm no more. I ain't gonna study to warm no more. Don't wanna study to warm no more. I ain't gonna study to warm no more. I ain't gonna study to warm no more. Ain't gonna study to warm no more. Ain't gonna study to warm no more. way down by the riverside, way down by the riverside, way down by the riverside, to the pool. My long watch will wait down by the riverside, sunny to warm the morn. I ain't gonna study the war no more. I ain't gonna study the war no more. I ain't gonna study to war no more. I ain't gonna study the war no more. Ain't gonna study the war no more. I ain't gonna study to war no more. Oh, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Yes, I am. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Hallelujah. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Well, something's got a hold on me. Oh, yes, it did. I said something's got a hold on me. I went to a meeting one night and my heart wasn't right. No, something's got a hold on me. Down by the riverside, way down by the riverside, way down by the riverside. Gonna lay down my burden, way down by the riverside. Gonna study to war no more. Ain't gonna study to war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more.
For sharing with us this morning, lay down our burdens. Indeed, we know joy is here, and we can praise God, and we can sing, and we can rejoice. At this, I'm going to invite Reverend Lester Willis to lead us to the throne of grace.
Good morning, everybody. I hope everyone's well. I truly hope everyone's well. And before I go into prayer, I just want to take a minute of your time this morning to let you know that if you are not taking care of yourself as far as this virus is concerned, I implore you, I plead with you this morning to do so. You never feel it until it hits home. So right now it has hit my home. And but for the grace of Jesus Christ, only God, I come before you this morning, thanking him for a fresh anointing over my son, my wife, and myself this morning. He has blessed us with this, again, this another morning with the gift of life, and we are truly grateful for it. So, but I tell you this morning, church, don't take this lightly. This is not a joke. Do not take it lightly. So let us go before the throne of grace this morning and ask God to continue to cover us and to continue to keep us as we go through this storm, because it is a storm. Every head bowed and every eye closed, and let us talk to this, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Most gracious and eternal Father God, we come this morning, God, your people just asking you, Lord Jesus, to continue to watch over us, to continue to keep us. God, we come this morning inviting you into our homes this morning, God, as we go about this church service. Heavenly Father, you are and always will be the guest of honor, God, in our lives, in our homes. Heavenly Father, I pray right now that you would just start right now, God, to bubble up into the spirits of each and every ear that's under the sound of my voice this morning, Heavenly Father, that they hear you and not me. Heavenly Father, I pray right now that you would just open up their hearts and their minds to the word, the broken bread of life that's going to be given to us this morning, Heavenly Father, by your servant. God, I pray right now that you will continue, Lord, to anoint us from the crowns of our heads to the soles of our feet. Heavenly Father, continue to bless us, Heavenly Father. Continue, Lord, to just be a light in these dark times. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray this morning. Heavenly Father, we turn this service over to you, that you would have your way and only your way, Lord Jesus. Let thy will be done. Heavenly Father, you are the great I am, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the Alpha and Omega. And yes, Lord, you are the beginning and the end. So we bless you this morning, Heavenly Father. We glorify you this morning, Heavenly Father. We reverence the name of your Son, Lord Jesus, this morning. Have thine own way, Lord. Have thine own way. And Heavenly Father, when this service is over, when this day is over, God, we will be careful, ever so careful, God, to give you and you alone all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, for you and you alone are worthy. We ask you these prayers and more, and no other name than your Son, our soon coming King, Jesus Christ, we pray. And God, we say thank you. Thank you for this gift that we do not take for granted, this gift of life. Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
And we continue to pray for healing.
Hallelujah.
Control. And so we continue to pray that God will move mightily in your home, as God continue to heal you. And this
thank
time
you.
I'm going to have the welcome done by Sister Patience.
Good morning, church family. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome each and every one of you to our virtual church service this morning. We extend a warm welcome to those worshiping with us here on Zoom, as well as those worshiping through Facebook and any other mediums. We thank God for your presence, and we do not take it for granted that you chose to spend your morning with us today. For those worshiping with us for the first time or for the second time, we want to extend a very special welcome to you on behalf of our pastor, Reverend Kanisha Black Newell, the ministerial staff, the steward board, and all the members of the Grand AME church family. We welcome you, and we are blessed to have you in our midst. We would love to connect with you, so please feel free to send us a message on our Facebook page, through email, or by giving us a phone call so that we can get to know you and we can share your prayer requests. We pray that your hearts will be blessed and refreshed by the service, and we hope that you will come again and worship with us sometime soon. Thank you.
Bless God. Thank you, Sister Patience. And I know by that welcome, we all feel as if we're at home. This is Liberty Hall, where we feel free to worship God wherever you're worshiping from. Whether you're joining in with us, we may not have gotten your name, but a warm welcome awaits you. At the end of the service, we will get some time to acknowledge you by name if you're on Zoom. So just stay tuned as we spend this time together in worship. At this time, we're going to have the reading of the scripture done by Sister Elvira.
The scripture reading is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 to 7. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn. Next slide, please. And provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. They will rebuild the ancient ruins and restore the places long devastated. They will renew the ruined cities that have been devastated for generations. Strangers Strangers will shepherd your flocks. Foreigners will work your fields and vineyards. Next slide. And you will be called priest of the Lord. You will be named ministers of our God. You will be fed on the wealth of nations, and in their riches you will boast. Instead of your shame, you will receive a double portion. And instead of disgrace, you will rejoice in your inheritance. And so you will inherit a double portion in your land, and everlasting joy will be yours. This is the words of God for the people of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, amen. God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus.
Jesus, that's why my heart
so good to us. We just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Isn't God good this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just go ahead and worship God in your own little space. Come on. I just want to thank you, Lord. You have been so good to us this morning. You have been faithful. And so, God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you, God. We thank you. We love you this morning, Lord. And so we offer praises unto your name this morning. Hallelujah. 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 God, Lord, God, we worship you this morning. We do not have enough words or tongues to praise you and to adore you, oh God, because you deserve so much, God. So Lord, we just offer you, oh God, hear these praises from grateful hearts this morning as we come to you, oh God, and we just say thank you. Bow your heads with me in prayer this morning. Father, we just want to thank you. We continue to praise you. We continue to magnify you, God. We thank you, God, that you sent your son in this world to come and to dwell among us. God, you sent your son, God, to bring hope and peace and joy in our lives so that we too can have that abiding in us, oh God. So Lord, we just want to thank you. We thank you, God, that when we were dying in sin, you reached down your hands and you thought of us. And even though, God, we have failed and we have messed up so many times, we thank you for grace. We thank you for mercy. We thank you for your favor. Even when, God, we have become so wretched in our own ways and our own doings, we thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you, God, that your thoughts are not our thoughts. Your ways are higher than our ways, God. God, we can't measure, oh God, how good you are. So Lord, we just thank you this morning. We thank you. Lord, as we come to hear your spoken words this morning, God, we ask that you will speak to every heart before you right now. Those who are on this church service, on Zoom, those who are listening through the airways, are those who will be listening, God. God, we ask that you'll send a word. A word, God, not only to encourage and to speak, God, but a word that will cause us to turn, oh God, and to seek you. A word that will lead to repentance and salvation. A word that will lead to us, oh God, acknowledging, oh God, that we are nothing without you. Father, we ask you to speak in our lives. Speak in our hearts, God. Cover us under your blood. Hide us behind the cross. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. My brothers and sisters, I want to take a few minutes to share a word that God has laid on my heart. If you remember, we started a theme in November, and it's to last for 2 months. We are overcomers. And it is so amazing how God has been leading and directing, that even as we journey through this season, even as we journey through this moment, even as we face the different things that we're facing in our lives and all around, we can declare boldly that we are overcomers. We are not overcomers because of what we have done. We are not overcomers because of anything else, but because of God. Because in all of this, if we can see the hands of God in everything that we do, then we can declare that we are overcomers. We are overcomers because we have the joy and the hope and the peace of God that lives within us when we accept him. And so this morning, I want to share a word that God has laid. We are overcomers because we have received the oil of joy.
It is very important on this, the second Sunday in December. Don't get it confused. It's the second Sunday in December, the third Sunday in Advent. Okay, so don't get it. It's a little bit confusing, I know, because it's the third Sunday in Advent, but it's not third Sunday, second Sunday. Amen. So let's bear that in mind. And so this Sunday, we want to allow God to pour his joy in our hearts. Pour his joy in our hearts. The oil of joy that will overflow in our lives. And for us to be an overcomer, we must receive the oil of joy in our lives. I want to spend a little time just to tell us the difference between joy and happiness. Because sometimes we crave happiness, but we don't crave joy. Sometimes we pursue happiness, but we don't pursue joy. Happiness is dictated by circumstances. Happiness comes when something good happens. So it's a circumstance that causes us to be happy. Joy is a deep, abiding emotion or feeling that resides in our soul. Joy is not dictated by external circumstances. So joy is simple. You can have joy in turmoil. You can have joy in sadness. You can have joy regardless of what is happening. Happiness is determined by circumstances. Amen. So joy is a state of mind and an orientation of the heart. That's where the focus lies, the heart. It is a settled state of contentment and confidence and hope in something. And this that we speak about is hope in God himself. Joy is more than circumstances. We can have joy in any circumstances. Amen. This joy is produced in us by the Holy Spirit as he causes us to see the beauty of Christ in his word and see the beauty of Christ in the world. So that is what joy is. Joy stands out regardless of. Bless God. Joy is a feeling, but here's the difference. It's a lasting emotion that arises out of a determined choice to praise God regardless of. That's joy. Happiness happens to us. It simply means that happiness is determined by what is happening around us. So we can choose to be happy because of the situation. So something good happens and we choose to be happy, right? Joy is something that is deeper. It comes from the heart. Happiness tends to be present. Happiness is not present in darkness and difficulty. Joy, as long as it abides in your heart, it's present. So in other words, your situation does not determine how you will respond. Let me explain that. What facing now, you can choose to have joy. You can choose to allow the joy to come forth. And that is what confuses the enemy. How can you have joy in all the things that I'm trying to do to destroy? How can you have joy? Right? And so we need to understand that joy can share its space with sadness and shame and anger, because joy is connected to something deeper than what we can explain. I hope I'm getting to somebody this morning. Joy is connected to the true vine. Joy is something, it doesn't matter if shame and anger and sadness is around, because you're connected, you are fed by that vine. And so nothing can hinder or take that joy away from you. My brothers and sisters, Isaiah prophetically spoke in chapter 61. And if you read it carefully and you look at it in depth, you recognize that he was speaking about the Messiah. He was speaking of the character and the office of the Messiah and what he was coming to do, the future, the promised future of blessedness of the church and the believers. The Messiah announced that he has come to heal what damage sin brings and causes. The Messiah preached good tidings to the poor, because sin causes us to be deprived. The Messiah comes to heal the broken heart, because sin breaks us apart and destroys us. The Messiah brings liberty to the captives, those in bondage. liberty to those who are spiritually bonded, and liberty to us, those who are physically in bonds and emotionally, because sin holds us in captivity and restricts us. The essence of it is that sin comes to depress, destroy, suppress, and oppress. That's the purpose of sin. But Isaiah declared that the Messiah was coming to restore, or to give us a different thing, or to transform, to exchange all of that for something else. Isaiah declared that this anointed one that we speak about, we call him Abba Father. Some of us call him Son of God, the Comforter, the Healer. We call him our Shalom, our Peace. We call him the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. We call him the Great I Am, the I Am that I Am. We call him the one who is the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. Some of us call him the Rose of Sharon, the Lily of the Valley. Some of us call him the Emmanuel. God is with us, our Advocate, our Almighty. Isaiah said he is coming to destroy the bondage that sin has on us. Isaiah declared it in Luke 2. Well, in Luke 2, when the angel of the Lord appeared to the shepherds in the field, and the shepherds got fearful, he said, "Be not afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people." My God. The shepherd, the angel declared, "I am bringing you good news. And this good news is going to cause everlasting joy for all people. A Savior is being born. His name is the Messiah. He is the Messiah, the Lord. The Messiah will cause great joy." And so I want to share with you three things that I want us to be mindful of that Isaiah spoke about. Isaiah spoke about it. Isaiah said, "He will give us beauty for ashes." Beauty for ashes. Ashes are associated with pain and symbolic of something that has been destroyed. My. If you have ever burnt anything, after the remnant is there, you look at it, the ashes are symbolic of something that has been destroyed or lost. The evidence that you see nothing that reminded you of what the thing used to look like. And the Isaiah said that this Messiah, this anointed one, is going to give you beauty for ashes. He's going to say, "Give me the ashes of your life, and in return, receive beauty." My God Almighty. Isaiah prophesied something that you and I are living today. Many of us, God found us in our brokenness. We were nothing but ashes before him. We were broken. We were empty. We were weak. What God created when we were born, when he looked at us, he saw ashes, because we were so messed up and tangled up in sin that nothing good didn't look like it was coming out of us. But then he said, "Give me your ashes and I'll give you beauty." And when we accepted Christ, he opened our eyes so that we could see beauty in ourselves. He opened our eyes so that others could see beauty in us. He opened our eyes so that we could behold his beauty in the world. Beauty for ashes, my brothers and sisters. And that is why we can rejoice in the joy that the Lord speaks about. He made something beautiful out of you and me. I don't know about you, but every time I think about what God has done to my ashes, I can just praise him. I can just give him praise and glory. I have not come from too far where I can't look back over my life and say, like the songwriter, "When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I've got a testimony, because God gave me beauty for my ashes." You may be carrying your ashes today. You may be saying, but God, it's nothing. You know, I don't know if you have ever had ashes in your hands. It just fades. It just all it does, it creates mess. And God said, don't worry yourself, because out of that ashes, there's a seed that has been planted. And I'm going to use that ashes to nurture that soil so that out of that ground will spring forth a flower, that it will be a sight to behold. I want to speak to somebody this morning. You don't have to be the ashes of nothing good, but God said, I want to make something beautiful out of you if you allow me to pour into your life. There is beauty and greatness behind every mark of darkness. Can I say that again? I want somebody to know that there is beauty and greatness behind every mark of darkness. Remain in God's joy, my brothers and sisters. Out of the ashes of your pain and your testings and your tribulation, a beauty is about to come forth. It doesn't matter what you're facing. Think about it. God said, I know that already. I have already made that way in, out of that way. So don't worry about anything. The joy that comes from God must abide in our soul, our heart, in the darkness, in difficulty, so we can experience the beauty. He gives beauty for ashes. The second thing, Isaiah said, the oil of joy for mourning. Matthew 5 verse 4, he said, blessed are they that mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. He gave us the oil of joy for mourning. Many of us, we mourn for different reasons. We mourn over the loss of someone or something. We mourn because there is brokenness and we need to be mended. We mourn because we feel shattered, because something has been taken from us. My God, we mourn because for one reason or the other. But the thing about mourning is that it brings us to a state of brokenness. Isaiah said, the oil of joy for mourning. The oil of joy transforms our brokenness. And I like the word when he said the oil of joy, because it simply means that God pours into us. And in the midst of the brokenness, the moment God starts pouring, the pieces start to come together. The scales and the dead things start to be shed away. He said the oil of joy for mourning. And the more he pours, the more you recognize that you can find joy in any situation. In the midst of loss, you find that the pieces are becoming to form together like a puzzle. And you start to smile because you see God's purpose unfold in your life. The oil of joy flows from our head to the soles of our feet. God opens our understanding and gives us his wisdom, so we can understand what is it that he's doing. And the moment our minds start to comprehend what is happening, then we start to react different. I want you to go with me in the spirit this morning. The oil of joy flows from the top to the bottom. So the transformation begins in the mind. That's why the scripture says, and be he renewed in your mind. Because that's where it starts. Because we can project happiness, but not of joy. We can be happy today, but still not have joy. Because joy is something that is deep down. Joy requires a transformation to take place in our lives. Understand, my brothers and sisters, that when the oil flows, the things that don't belong must be discarded off. There's a stripping away of the dead skin and remnants of our pain. Because in the midst of everything, we need to understand that God is our joy. If only we would allow him to pour his joy in our lives now, then we will see the beauty of Christ in all things. The oil of joy replaces our temporary state of happiness, which is only dictated by external circumstances, and it replaces it and gives us a permanent state of joy. My brothers and sisters, let me tell you about this oil of joy. When believers and unsaved come in contact with him, they respond by rejoicing. I want to remind you of the Samaritan woman. When she went to this well and she met Jesus and she had an encounter with Jesus, the Bible said she dropped what she had and she ran to the town to tell others, rejoicing about this man that she met who transformed her life. She received the oil of joy that she could proclaim and declare who God was. I want to remind you in Luke 17 of the 10 lepers who were cleansed and healed. And the Bible said only one returned to praise and rejoice. When you come in contact with that oil of joy, there's a transformation that takes place in your mind, in your heart, that is portrayed externally, that all you can do is rejoice. The oil of joy that we talks about, it breaks yokes. It destroys burdens. It brings freedom to those who are held in bondage. And it causes us to find comfort in God. While others mourn without hope, we don't mourn without hope. God wants to pour the oil of joy over us. Every oppression, depression, is from the enemy himself. And Jesus came to destroy that so that you and I can have joy. What does that mean? It means that we will still endure and suffer because of our faith, but we have joy. We will still face tribulation, but we have joy. We will still face persecution, but we have joy. We will still be spoken about and everything else, but we have joy. My brothers and sisters, this joy that I speak about, the world didn't give it to you. The world didn't give it so they can't take it from us. And once we understand that, then we walk in the flow of the oil of joy. The third thing Isaiah said, he will give us garments of praise for a spirit of heaviness, meaning that we will be clothed with thankfulness and gratitude. It is ironic that Isaiah used or proclaimed garments of praise for a spirit of heaviness. So praise and weakness goes hand in hand, meaning that when we are clothed, when we clothe ourselves with the garment of praise, it doesn't matter how weak we get, we praise God in the midst of our weaknesses. Because Paul declared that in my times of weaknesses, his strength is made perfect. Our garments of praise show to others that we know God's truth. A garment of praise shows that we are strong in the Lord. A garment of praise shows that we refuse to accept the enemy's lies, that we are too weak to handle whatever he throws at us. Our garments of praise tell us that we refuse to be knocked down and stay there. Yes, you can knock me down, but like an eagle, I will rise again. A garment of praise says, yes, you knock me down, but while I'm down there, I'm going to praise my way up. A garment of praise tells us that we acknowledge where our strength comes from. Maybe you have a spirit of heaviness. Maybe you feel heavy in your heart for something. I don't know what it is. Isaiah said he will give you a garment of praise for a spirit of heaviness. Because your garment of praise is what you wear wherever you go. Your garment of praise is not caused by culture. Your garment of praise is not fake. But it's a conscious realization that praise is who you are. That's why the songwriter said, praise is who I am, even when I'm going through. Praise is what I do. My circumstances, they don't stand a chance. Because I will praise my way through. I will praise my way through every situation. Even when I don't know what else to do, I will praise God in everything that I endure. The oil of joy must flow. And then Isaiah said, all that beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garments of praise for a spirit of heaviness, all that so we may be called trees of righteousness, being planted by the Lord to display and bring glory to him. All that so that you and I could become trees of righteousness, a tree that is planted by the rivers of water that will bring forth fruit in its season, a tree that is planted in the soil called Jesus Christ, that pursues righteousness, that pursues peace, that pursues joy and faith in the Lord, that lives upright and walk holy and live in right standing with God. My brothers and sisters, let us not leave today without recognizing why Jesus came to this earth, so we can have beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garments of praise for the spirit of heaviness, and so that we can be planted at trees of righteousness and bring him glory. I want us to receive the oil of joy today, not fake joy as the world gives it to us, as the world tells us, try to dictate to us what joy looks like, that somebody got to do good for you to have joy, that all has to be well for you to have joy. Not that joy that I talk about. That joy is masked by something else. But a joy that comes from hope in God and a peace in God. If you are listening this morning and you have heard the word of God, it may not be as long as you wanted to, but you heard something this morning that you knew God is saying to you this morning. God wants us to know that he wants to pour the oil of joy in our lives. Some of us are going through some rough times. Some of us are dealing with some struggling things. Some of us are questioning God. Some of us are asking questions. Some of us are fighting battles. Some of us are in spiritual warfare. God said, I want to give you the oil of joy. All you have to do is open up and receive it. Receive the oil of joy. It's already done. I want to pray with somebody this morning. You're listening. You're not saved. You might be saved. You might have walked away from God. God wants you to know that he has a plan for you. He said, I want to take that ashes and give you beauty. But I want you to accept me in your heart. Not just say it with your mouth, but with your heart. I want you to accept. The difference is that sometimes we say it, but our heart is not where our mouth is. So God said, I want you to accept me in your heart. Because when you start accepting Christ in your heart, then there are things that he starts to strip away. And the first thing is change our thinking and our mindset. I want to pray with us this morning as we go to God. And if you're able, I want you to lift your hands as we allow God to pour in our lives this morning. As we allow God to pour in our hearts. Father, we come to you right now. We thank you, God, that you are the God of peace, of hope, the God of love, and the God of joy. And so this morning, as Isaiah prophesied and declared, that Lord, you came to give us beauty for our ashes. Every situation that we are facing right now, that we are not even able to verbalize to you, God. Father, we smile, but we carry hurt and pain. Lord, we do all the things that we think we need to do, but we don't have joy, God. So, Lord God, we ask you at this time to take our ashes and give us your beauty. Cause, God, cause us to flourish in the midst of desolate places. God, give us the oil of joy for mourning. Those who mourn, God, they will be comforted. So, God, we ask you to pour from the crown of our head to the very soles of our feet. Mighty God of Daniel, when you start pouring, God, then there's transformation that takes place. So God, as you pour in our lives this morning, take the spirit of heaviness from us, God, and give us garments of praise that we can praise you in any circumstances. Lord, you see the hearts of your people. Lord, you know where our heart is, God. So we ask you to have your way right now. Somebody's crying out. Somebody needs you right now. Every situation that is before you right now, every broken heart, every pain, every suffering, everything, God, that we face, pour your oil of joy in our lives. And let us be like trees of righteousness planted, that God, we will bring forth fruit in due season. Father, we ask all these mercies and we say thank you. Thank you, God, for pouring the oil of joy in our lives. We say thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God's name be praised this morning. My brothers and sisters, receive the oil of joy. Whatever you're going through, whatever you will go through, receive the oil of joy. There's a song that said, don't let nobody steal your joy. Joy in the Lord, joy in the Holy Ghost. The Lord will give you what you need to go through. The Lord will give you the strategies that you need. Don't let no one steal your joy. And if you're listening this morning, and you have not accepted Christ in your heart, I want to introduce to you our Savior, our Lord and Savior. Last week we said, realize that God loves you. Admit or confess that you are sinful and spiritually dead. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and accept him in your heart. The Bible tells us that if we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart, then we shall be saved. You may be listening this morning and you may have said, but I've tried that and I found it so difficult. I want you to reach out to us so that we can help you along this journey. You can call us. We will get back to you. You can send us a message. We will help you along the way. The Lord promises us that he will never leave nor forsake us. The Lord promises us that he will be with us in all things. That's one assurance I can guarantee you of. So I invite you to give your heart to the Lord. I invite you to recommit your life to him. I invite you to trust him in this time. Why not extend your hands to God? and say, Lord, I accept you in my heart. So I take this few seconds to pray that you will accept Christ in your heart. Father, we pray for those who may be listening, who may not have accepted you as their Lord and Savior. God, or they accepted you at one point, but have found themselves walking out of your will, struggling, God, and hopeless, not knowing what to do. Father, we lift up your children before you. We pray, God, that you will come into their hearts. We pray, God, that they will accept you as Lord and Savior. They will believe in you and trust in you. Have your way right now as we await the testimonies of what you're doing. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Bless God. At this time, I'm going to ask Brother Chris to do our giving while we'll have a selection from Brother Jeremiah.
Good morning, church. First of all, I would like to thank those of you who have been so faithful in your tithing and keeping up your commitments to God. We thank you. For those who have yet to tithe, we offer you various ways to give to the ministry of Grant. First of all, you can email, e-transfer your money. The address is giving@grant@gmail.com. Or you can donate through our website at www.grantame.com and click on the donate button. You can also do it the old-fashioned way and drop it to our church in person at 2029 Girard Street East, at just one block east of Girard and Woodbine. Thank you again for your gracious donating to the work of the Lord.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Brother Chris.
I heard an old story, how my Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of cross blood atoning, and some sweet day I sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and brought me beneath his cleansing flood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his healing, of his blood's power revealing, how he made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came up there and brought the victory. Well, oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and brought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior, saved forever. He taught me and brought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Victory, victory is mine.
Hallelujah. Victory in Jesus. Hallelujah. Indeed, we have the victory this morning. Hallelujah. God's name be praised. At this time, we're going to have the announcements done by Sister Robin.
All right. Am I unmuted? Yes.
You are.
Okay. Thank you. The Steward Board special announcement. It's that time of year again to show our love to Pastor Kenesha Blake Newell and to wish her a very Merry Christmas and a happy, prosperous, and blessed New Year. Please mark Pastor's gift in the memo section of the e-transfer or personal checks. The members of the Grant Steward Board wish all of you God's richest blessings. Prayer concerns and requests, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all of the Lord's people. And that's Ephesians 6:18. And our list this morning is Sister Shirley Hunter, Sister Lorraine Downey, Brother Ozzie and Sister Jackie Roberts, Sister Darlene Smith, Sister Cindy Brown, Sister Cindy Gray, Sister Heather Von Atziken, Sister Wanda Williams, Brother Chris Hobbs, Brother George Stephen and the Stephen family, Sister Muriel Douglas, Michelle and Marcus Hernandez, Sister Doris Jones, and Alda Arthur, and I'm going to add you, Reverend Willis, to this prayer list. Please keep these people in prayer. Remember the call to fasting and prayer, Wednesdays from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Is not this the fast that I choose? To loose the bonds of wickedness and to undo the straps of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? And that's Isaiah 58:6. Join us on the prayer line Wednesdays from 11 to 12 noon. The dial-in number is 1-867-292-3030. And the access code is 7006901#. The prayer circle connection. Stay connected. Find some time this week to reach out to someone. Our youth Sunday school for all age groups is today, Sunday at 2:30 p.m. using the same link for the worship service. Join us for Bible study on Zoom every Wednesday at 7 p.m. And we are a lively group, so please join. The White Gift Christmas Hamper Project, I believe the list is closed now, but we are still receiving donations as this project is a very expensive undertaking. So we're inviting families and businesses within our community to sponsor a family by making a $50 donation. You can make a contribution to our White Gifts Christmas Hamper Project by e-transfer at givingatgrant@gmail.com. And just mark that in your memo, or you can mail it to the church. The Sunday School Nativity Craft Scene. Create your own nativity scene at home using household items. Make it a family fun activity for parents and children. Please do not submit a store-bought nativity scene. Prizes will be given for various categories. You can make the video or take a picture and submit it to the church email. And the deadline is today, Sunday, December the 13th. And the Christmas soiree from the lay organization is tonight at 6:30 p.m. The Zoom address is, ID 848-723-7970. The passcode is 7642 if you log on to Zoom and enter in those. And Calvary Baptist Church on Main Street is inviting us to their traditional lessons and carols by candlelight, by virtual candlelight, tonight at 7 p.m. You can join them after the lay soiree. The address for that is https://webinar.gomeet.com/221-873-746. Phone in number to connect is 437-887-2516. And our food bank. We are still serving people from on Wednesdays from 2 to 6, but there will be no food bank per se, but we will be serving dinners. So you can still come from 2 to 6 and receive a dinner to go. And that's our announcements for today. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Sister Robin, for the announcements. And so my brothers and sisters, as we come to the end of our service, want to thank you all for joining in. Let us pronounce the benediction, then we can have a time of fellowship and praise. Father, we just want to thank you for this opportunity to share through this medium to your people. We thank you for all those who are joined in. We thank you for all those who have listened in. Oh God, as we are about to go, God, we pray that you will continue to pour your blessings upon us, whatever activities, whatever is going to take place during the course of this week, and even during the course of this month, we hand it over to you and we say, have your way. Father, we give you the praise, we give you the glory. We are overcomers. We receive the oil of joy. May the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon us and give us his peace, his hope, and his joy in now and forevermore. And we all say, amen. And amen. Amen.
Bless God.